It was Monday, April 20th. It was windy in Los Angeles. We were working the day watch out of traffic division, hit-and-run felony detail. My partner's Frank Smith. The boss is Captain Calfee. My name's Friday. An aching wisdom tooth had kept me awake most of the night. I had an appointment with a dentist, and I was trying to stop the pain until then. I wasn't having much luck.
Hi, Joe.
Morning, Frank.
How's tooth?
Not much better. Still aching.
That's rough.
A lousy thing kept me awake most of the night.
You check with that dentist I told you about?
Yeah, I did. He says it's a wisdom tooth. This one right up here.
Let's see it.
Well, it's this one here.
Well, don't you want to show me?
No, not particularly.
Well, I'd like to see it.
Why?
Well, Joe, I know a little about wisdom teeth.
Anyway, the dentist says it's got to come out. I'm supposed to see him this afternoon.
Joe, my sister had the same trouble.
Is that right?
Yeah, she had him out. Wisdom teeth. Really hurt. Impacted. You know what that means? Jammed right up in there. Just hanging onto that jawbone.
Yeah, I know.
Had to pull them right out. Hurt terrible.
Yeah.
Hey, Joe.
Yeah?
Turn around this way, will you? A little more. Now, turn the other way. Yes, sir.
Well, what's the matter now?
Puffy.
What?
Your face is all swollen. It's puffy.
Yeah, well, it didn't look that way to me in the mirror.
You take my word for it, Joe. Face is swollen. Right there, see? Puffy.
Yeah, it sure is tender.
I imagine it is, Joe. Sure is funny about wisdom teeth, isn't it?
What's that?
Well, some people never do get them. I never did.
Is that right?
Yeah. I got all the rest. No wisdom teeth. My sister had them, though.
Yeah, you told me about that.
She had them pulled. And that's another funny thing.
What?
Well, even after she had them taken out, she could still feel them.
She could, huh?
Yeah, for 5 or 6 days, they still hurt.
This is after she had them pulled?
Yeah, 5 or 6 days. I forget exactly how many, but they still hurt. They weren't there. Still hurt. Funny, isn't it?
Yeah, that sure is.
Well, don't you worry about it, Joe. The old doc will yank them right out. You'll feel a lot better then, too.
Sure.
Much better. Yes, sir. 5 or 6 days. Still hurt.
Yeah, did you see the skipper this morning?
Hmm? Oh, yeah, I ran into him down the hall. Got something here we're supposed to check out.
Now, what do you got?
Dead body report.
What's the story on it?
Well, the victim's Edward Raymond Stokes, 732 Delano Street, apartment 2. His body was found in a gutter near 63rd and Vermont. 3 o'clock this morning. No witnesses. Only one piece of evidence.
Yeah.
Skid marks near the body, that's all. Apparent hit and run.
Where's the body now?
Neighborhood mortuary out there. Emerald Hills Funeral Home. One of the deputy coroners handled the body, a fellow named Jonathan Larimore.
Anybody claim the body yet?
No.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah. The skipper says if we need any help, Rogers and McClendon are on hand.
That's fine. I don't know, how do we manage to draw all the choice ones? Do you know?
I guess we live right. Huh?
Skid marks and a dead body.
Yeah.
Well, guess we better get on it, huh?
Right. Hey, what time are you supposed to see the dentist?
I'm supposed to call him about 12:30. He'll tell me that. Doesn't look like we'll be able to make it now, does it?
You should take care of that, Joe. Sure is funny.
What's that?
My sister. Same thing. Had them pulled. Her wisdom teeth. 5 or 6 days later, they still hurt. Really tough. 5 or 6 days.
Yeah, you told me. I remember.
You should try to get to that dentist today, though, Joe. You really should.
Well, the way you lay it out, it really doesn't make much difference, does it?
Huh?
I still got 5 or 6 days.
Joe.
Well,
fine. Hi. Glad you're in early. That stuff is floating all over the squad room.
Yeah. Thought for a minute it was Ann's handwriting, but it isn't.
Somebody you know?
Yeah.
You're early.
Yeah. I want to go over to Georgia Street and see the doc.
What's the matter?
I don't know. I couldn't sleep last night. Started getting headaches, ringing in my ears. I don't know what it is.
Stay right there.
What?
Got it. My locker. Fix you right up.
What are you talking about?
The headaches. Get worse when you move around, huh?
What?
When you move around, your head feels worse?
Yeah.
Feels like it's gonna blow up?
Yeah.
Huh. Glad you came to me, Joe. I know what it is. Got the stuff right here. There. There we are. Take two of those. Fix you right up.
What is it?
Salt.
Salt?
Salt, that's your trouble. You don't get enough salt. Same thing happened to me last summer. Ever since then, I keep a bottle of salt tablets right in my locker. Always ready. Take two. Fix you right up.
All right, you got a penny?
What for, a cup?
Yeah.
That's something else, Joe. We're not going to drink that water anymore.
No?
Nope. Bought a whole case of this just for us. You can drink it right out of the bottle.
What is it?
Poland water. Right from the spring. Real water. You can read right here on the bottle. Poland Spring, Maine. Picked you right up.
Well, maybe I ought to wait until I see the doctor, huh?
Joe, believe me, I know what's wrong. Happened to me, same thing. Salt. That's what you need. Your body's screaming for salt. There you are. Poland water and the pills. Go ahead.
Well, now, look, Frank, I really appreciate it. Really, I do. But I think I ought to see the doctor, huh?
Joe, don't you trust me?
Well, yeah.
Take the pills.
Salt.
Salt. Here, take them.
One at a time, all right?
You know better than that, Joe.
I just thought I'd ask. You're the doctor.
One at a time. Doesn't make any difference with pills, Joe.
Doesn't it?
Lots of water. Now, that wasn't bad, was it?
No, that's good water.
Now, if the headaches don't go away, we can drop by Georgia Street and see the doc. Well, let me have that bottle, Joe. Cap it up. Keep it fresh for us.
Wait a minute.
Yeah?
Want those?
Always ready.
Anything doing?
Yeah.
Wednesday, December 24th. We were working the day watch out of burglary division. The boss is Captain Bernard. My partner's Frank Smith. My name's Friday.
Hi, Joe.
Hi.
Christmas cards, huh? A little late, aren't you?
Well, I was going to send them out Monday, but we had that stakeout.
You ought to get married, Joe.
Yeah?
It's the only system. Faye does all that stuff for me. Laundry, mails cards. Only system.
Might help.
We got a big stack there.
I ought to cut down the list. Look at this here, upholstery shop.
Yeah?
They send me a card every year. I never get anything upholstered.
Faye and I ought to go over our list. Cut off a few names. I brought in your present. Want to open it now?
No, I'll wait.
I always open a couple the day before.
Why?
Well, put you in the spirit ahead of time. I opened Phil's this morning.
Who's he?
Faye's brother in Denver. Gave me a magazine, one of those funny ones.
What do you mean, a comic book?
No, one of those funny ones, you know.
No, I don't, Frank.
Well, some of the pages have holes in them. You look through and there's a picture on the next page.
Oh, yeah, I've seen those on the newsstand.
They have cloth pasted in.
Cloth?
In the ads. If you want to buy a suit, they have a sample right there.
You mean you can feel it?
Reach right out and feel it. There was one for $200.
A suit?
Sure. Cloth comes from Scotland.
What's it made out of? Solid gold?
No, they got a special kind of goat over there. It's real smooth.
Not a goat, Frank. A sheep.
Well, it's a special kind of sheep, then, because a suit costs $200.
You gonna get one?
I told Faye. She said, wear the sample. Anything doing?
Fanning and Pryor were in on that market holdup.
They come up with anything?
Pound of air, nothing else.
I hope it stays quiet. I got more shopping to do.
I finished.
What'd you get, Ann?
Stationery set, some paper and envelopes, leather binding.
Joe, you'll never learn.
Oh, what's the matter?
No woman wants a stationery set. Get her something personal.
Well, it's got her initials on it.
No, no. You want something more sentimental, romantic.
What'd you get Faye?
It's different in her case.
What'd you get Faye?
Sewing machine.
That's romantic.
Well, it is in a way.
Why didn't you buy her a catcher?